everyone. Welcome to my channel. I'm here to show you my completed mixed media journal that I've recently just completed early last month in March 2021. So as you can see from the title here, I started this journal from 2018. So I ended March 2021. And you can see here is this thick, and it's all full of just mixed media spreads. So this was a originally a this is what I got, an extra one for my next journal version 2, and it's from a brand called Monologue. I believe it's by a company by Malaysia, and it's A5 with 200 GSM. And I just thought that initially I really stressed out on getting a good mixed media journal for my journal. So I wanted a moleskin notebook, but thinking it over, I thought the spine will be one hell of a problem, and I thought this one was just good enough for me, this kind of, you know, elastic. And yeah, I can't wait to use my second Monologue one. So this one is actually not my first attempt at mixed media art journaling. This is actually my second art journal, but this is what I consider my first serious mixed media journal, because my first one was this, and I won't show it to you because it's just not good artwork. It was actually a sketchbook given as a gift from my friend who came back from India. So yeah, so anyway, let's get on to this. That was my cover for this. So yeah, before that, I have to say that initially when I started this journal, I did not work page by page. Sometimes I will just jump from one page to another just for the sake of getting a good balance on the book. So this was not one of not my first art spread. But anyway, most of my initial art spreads were mostly done in watercolors, and this is just one of them. And as you can see, I had this idea of having a hopscotch watercolor chalk, you know, this kind of thing on the road. And I had this vision in my dreams, having that in the middle of a city road. And this is like a Manhattan road in New York. And if you can see here, there's an NBC. Of course, NBC Rockefeller Center does not look anything like that. It's just what I envision it. And so yeah, just a silly thing that I wanted to do, and I finally did it. This one is I'm a fan. I'm not a fan of anything, but I'm mostly a shipper. I ship a lot of characters, actors, and this is actually these two actors, Sanaya and Barun. They acted in this Indian show called Is Pyar Ko Kya Naam Do, and I really love them together. And this is just a part of it. And I actually, at the back of, if you can see, I actually used some magazine as a background, and all these are got some paste in. All these are modeling paste. I just tried my first modeling paste here, I believe. And all these are still watercolors, just watercolors. And I used this, I believe I used an acrylic black ink for this. I'm still not a good calligrapher, and this was still just my first time trying to, you know, do some calligraphy. And this is my favorite, one of my favorites, Jimmy Fallon. And if you follow me on Instagram, you know I'm a Jimmy Fallon fan. So I actually printed this on, believe it or not, inkjet printer. And so of course the printing quality is not that good, but it works for me. So all this I actually typewritten. I have a antique typewriter, so I use that to type some of the journaling quotes. Actually use a stencil here, and mostly just splatter watercolors here and there. This one, I believe it was an inspiration from, I can't remember what's her name, Vicky? Yes, it's one of those popular mixed media artists on YouTube. And I tried to do that using some string, I did some tea bags. So yeah, I did this, have cups of positivity. I think it's one of my favorites, yeah. Just again, just watercolor with background using magazine cutouts. You can see some text over there. And all these are just scrapbook. I used to be a scrapbooker, as many of us mixed media artists are. We scrapbook a lot, and we still till date have a lot of balance of scraps here and there. So I just use some of them here. And this was actually an idea I actually used in my old childish mixed media journal. I actually just tried to recreate it in a new way. I'm a Starbucks addict, you know. So you know the Starbucks is, the logo herself is a mermaid. So I took Ariel and just recreate her into the Starbucks mermaid. Just made her hair, I recolored her hair using green, I believe I used green marker. So I just added that crown, using that crown and everything, and meet Ariel and her just holding Starbucks cups, you know. So even mermaids need coffee. I believe it's one of these popular quotes on the internet. So I just use that. And again, just watercolors. And actually all this, I used varieties of things like toilet paper rolls and bottle caps, just to, you know, dip white paints, to just stamp paints here and there for the bubbles. This one I'm not proud of. It's actually also inspired by someone, I can't remember who it was, but I tried to recreate it my own way and it just did not work. The idea was supposed to be something simple and basic, and it just did not turn out right for me. The colors are nice to me, but just didn't work out. This one again, I believe it was also inspired by another artist. Again, I'm so sorry if any one of you out there recognize this as something similar to some other artists online, do tell me who they are. Because initially, when I first started this mixed media journal, I did not take down all those artist names. I just take pictures, screenshot, and you know, keep them for later inspiration whenever I wanted to do something, you know, mixed media. And it's just one of them. And this was actually a magazine cutout, a black and white cutout, and the model herself was wearing something furry, but it was not furry enough. And most of all, I could not cut out all those furs for this spread. So as you can see here, I don't know if you can catch all that, I used just brush, black brush marker to add on more furs onto her coat. And I actually watercolored yellow to her hair to just synchronize all the colors, because I just wanted all this. I believe I used just blue, green, black and white. Yeah. No, not green, yellow. Sorry about that. So This one, this part will feel, especially this white scribbles. I wanted it to be as thin as this. I used a dip pen, and it just did not work out for this white ink. And as does this. Actually, I wanted I wanted to burn the edges of this pieces of paper, but again, I failed at that. So I just use ink to outline, to give that messy outline. This one, again, I'm not happy with this. I believe I did use watercolor for the background, but for the cactuses, well, I used green poster paints, and that's why I believe I did not protect this when I closed the book. So you can see all this all stuck and very old and all. Quite unhappy with this. And poster paint, I just not one of the good mediums for you to paint on a book which you plan to close for a long while, as you can see here. And I believe this one was also an inspiration from, I believe, an Instagram post by someone. This one I quite like. I really like this because of the color. My favorite color is yellow, by the way. So you can see why. I actually use all this. I believe these two. No, these three. If you can see the leaves here. You can see that. All these are papers from some old advertisement flyers I get in my mailbox. So I just use them to cut out. Don't waste paper, you know. So I just use them to cut out shapes for my flowers and leaves. And this girl was from a magazine, a community magazine I got for free. I just cut her out and some more. She was holding a paintbrush and did just wanted me to cut her out. I just smile. Yeah. I just use a stamp, and I was not really familiar with inks, so I used a water-based ink. So you can see some of the ink just smeared when in touch with water. So yeah, most of them here. These are all doodles. Quite happy though with it. It's still my journal. This one, wow, this one took so many days for this, I believe. Not just because of the mandalas, because of the background. And like I told you, when I first started doing this mixed media journal, I use no other wet coloring mediums but just watercolors and poster paints. So whenever I tried to, you know, doodle this with my whatever black markers I use this for with, the colors just smeared along with it, and I had to redo, and I can't even remember how long this one spread took me to finish. But yeah, I'm still quite happy with it. It's just hanging decoration. This one, Harry Potter. Who doesn't love Harry Potter? I'm a Potterhead. I love Harry Potter. So, yep, and just like Harry Potter style, I wanted to do a wax seal. I own a wax seal a lot. But again, one thing about me is that I do not like thick, very, very thick things to be stuck on my spreads. Because I try to avoid thick things because I want to properly close my journal. You know, I know it's an impossible fit when you're doing mixed media journal, but I try to make it as thin as possible. So this was not something that I was not a good decision for me. It just too thick for me. But yeah, I think I quite like it. Again, I printed this on inkjet printer. This one, I love this one. But again, unfortunately, this is not my original idea. This was, I believe it was from an artist, an online artist from Instagram. Again, I did not record whoever her handle, whatever her handle was, because like I said, I never record when I first started this. So if you know who this is originally from, do comment below. All this, I just hand drawn this, and most of them I just use dry sponge and just, you know, blot them all over to get the background, and just use some stencils, some black stamps, and just I did some brown drip, you know, so you can see all these drips of watercolors. And this one I use the what do you call it, the 3D embossing device. Yeah, and one thing though, I have to tell you, if I use this embossing device twice in this journal, and this thing cannot be in touch with heat, because once it get in touch with heat, the all the words will disappear. That I learned that from this journal. Again, this one was also inspired by someone from Instagram who I also did not record down. I believe this one is very, I copied her very very intently. Although this one I use, I printed something on this, I don't know if you can see. It's actually on a tracing paper. Actually that there's some text on it, but upon painting on it, all the water just smeared because I use inkjet paper. So I redid it and just use my, you know, permanent marker to write the quotes. This one I actually like it. I really love this page. I don't know why, but it was not that popular on my IG post. I love it because I just use you know, basic watercolor, but it gave that you know, that washed away wooden look, and I love that. It looks almost natural wood like that. So yeah, all these circles I use toilet rolls, you know, just blot it, stamped it with my pins. And again, I use my typewriter, my old typewriter, for the journaling quotes. This one though, this one I had so much expectation from this. But it did not result with what I had in mind. But I was quite happy with it. It was supposed to be a unicorn with dangling stars. This was my first time using, if you can see, golden paint. Oh yeah, I use some white gel pen. And I actually, for the horn, I actually use this modeling paste. Color it with some a mixture of pink, blue and gold. I really love this one. This one I got inspired from a children's drawing. I don't know which kid did it. It was pasted on the wall of someone. I can't remember where it was. So I thought, why not recreate that? Just a simple children, kiddish drawing of a building, of buildings, and paste that on a starry night. Although it, of course, it just does not dwell with the whole atmosphere, but I think I like it. Just a contrast of art styles. Ah, this one does not. I did not like this one. Again, because of the tracing paper. I really thought that I could blend the tracing paper well, but this is a second time I tried using tracing paper as quotes, but I think this is my last time ever using it. I gave up using it. And this is also a manic of Tom Felton and Emma Watson. I printed it using inkjet paper. Not my favorite work, really. Again, this one is not a favorite at all. This was my second spread I ever did on this journal. That's why you can see all this very amateur mixed media journaling. I just plastered every single stencil or stems. This is again, I shipped them to Miss Senaya and Ashish from their TV show Rang Rahasia. I did use a lot of modeling paste here and just watercolor everywhere. And this is my first time actually using gesso. I did not know how to use gesso, so if you can see closely here, a lot of streaks. And I believe this one though, I believe I printed this using a laser printer, not mine, but from the ministry office that I used to work in. Free printing, you know, you never know, but it's good print. And this one is also my favorite. They are all magazine cutouts from an IKEA magazine. So I cut out a sofa, a shelf, this rice paper lamp, and I just doodled a cat here, a plant, a clock, and I just used some modeling paste and just give it a background. And I tried to do it through drew a border for it, just give some pigment shadow or border for it. Quite like it. This one was my favorite, but my first spread I ever did on this journal. Again, this one I printed this the same time I printed this. So I used the same laser printer at my office. So yeah, that I used a lot of things that I taught what mixed media journaling should be. I used modeling paste, and I used this leftover of my die cards. I can't remember where this is from, but again, this was a lesson taught. I did not love using thick die cards because it's just too thick for my taste. I prefer very thin paper. So this was the first and the last time I ever used this kind of die cards in my journal. This one is an old favorite of mine, mainly because it's one of my first few spreads that I did that I'm actually happy with. As you can see, it's Draco Malfoy and Hermione Granger from Harry Potter and Half-Blood Prince. I just basically just use some watercolor and some couple of modeling paste here. And this was, again, I'm not super happy with this, but I use those kind of those kind of mini wooden alphabet stamps for each and every one of these words, because at that point of time I did not have enough art supplies, so I just use whatever I have with. And also, again, I printed this using my inkjet printer, so the print quality is not that good. I just use clear gesso on them to prevent them from, you know, smearing it as much. It worked well, okay, but not that good. This one is an embarrassment to me. I was not happy with this at all. I just use basic poster paints with this, and I believe I saw this someone doing something similar, and I wanted to recreate that. so it did not work for me. I just used some strips of colors from the poster paints and just used, I believe I used a black marker for this thing to do that negative kind of journaling. Again, this is the second time I used the 3D embossing device. I had to redo this. This was actually the second time I pasted this, because like I said, I did some heat embossing from the other page behind, and when I turned back, all the alphabets had gone, so I had to redo it. And this was it. Definitely not something I was happy with. I had great expectation for this, but I guess my art creativity was just not with me at that point of time. This was from this is actually an actress called Shraddha Kapoor. This is a still from her movie, I believe, Egg Villain. And I love that movie because her character in the movie also keeps art journal, you know, just as thick as mine. And she does some photo journaling and some paints and everything in the movie. Of course, I don't think it's the actress who did it herself. But yeah, so I wanted to do something for that. But it just came out well too basic and just not something I'm proud of. So on to the next. This one is something used to trend with art journaling at one point of time. Just use some waves and, you know, write along those waves. And I just did some brush lettering here and there. I can't remember what I used to stamp this circles and everything, but yeah, here's some modeling base. Again, just plain watercolor. And I believe for this red, if you can see here, all this were gessoed in, because I believe I did some mistake. So I just gessoed in the color and repainted with red. And I believe this white washer is also using gesso. This one, I can't remember where I got this, where I was inspired this. This one I can't remember who I was inspired from. I believe I did credit the person on my Instagram when I posted this. Can't believe who this was from, but anyway, I did this in my own version with some almost invisible drawings or run things at that point of time. I think that this is a point of time where I was so stressed out with my ministry work, you know, at the office. I was just ranting away, using my art journal as a vehicle for me to de-stress. And actually for this, I think this is one of the first time I used paper napkins as the background. If you can see here, all these are paper napkins. Just use it. And it's just watercolor over it. And this is, again, all these paper shapes. I believe these were also just some old advertisement flyers that I use to paint watercolors on it. And just random, cut out random shapes of leaves. Become like, make them look as if there's some plant pots or something. I'm quite happy with this. This one, I believe is also, I did credit the person. I'm sorry, I don't have notes with me right now, so I can't remember who the exact artist is, but I believe I did credit whoever this online artist I was inspired from on my IG post for this spread. And yeah, this one was also, I used tissue paper. I don't know if you can see some flowery tissue paper here, but it's now almost invisible with all my paints, but there are some here you can see everywhere. So Yeah, I actually used to. I print this using, again, with inkjet printer. I don't own a laser printer at home because it's just too expensive for me. So I just use my inkjet printer and just carefully not make sure that the ink doesn't run off. And here I just use stenciling with polka dots and everything. Now all these are scribbles. Scribbles. Stencil and A. This is Aishwarya Rai. Her initial. This one was quite a favorite. And I got quite a couple of positive remarks on my IG post for this. It's Tom Felton, by the way, if you don't know him, who plays Draco Malfoy in the Harry Potter films. I used some, I can't remember, some scrapbook paper as the background, and just used cards, you know, old cards, and just stamped some lines using my black ink. The modeling paste, again inkjet paper print. I use clear gesso on it, and I actually use a yellow, you can see here, a yellow dolly, paper dolly, small one. Again, like I say, I initially when I had this journal, I just used water-based inks to stamp my, you know, stamps. So if you can see, some of the ink just run, just got smeared a bit. This one, I'm quite happy with it. It's just basic art journaling, just magazine cut out, and some. This is also a magazine cut out that I repainted with my color pencils and watercolor. I use a washi tape here, some stamps, again water-based inks. This is what happens to them when in touch with water. This one, I actually love this, but it's nothing extraordinary about this, but I just love the colors, the softness, the comfort it gives. And it's also, it's actually a magazine cut out for a print ad for some, I believe, some school academic thing, I don't know. And basically I when I look at it, it does look like something that, you know, a print ad for a detergent, for a cloth, you know, softener or something. Yeah, this one, I believe I use a silver, I don't know if you can see that, some silver paints with the stencils. Let me catch the light. Then I used for this whole journaling, I actually traced over a printout and just pasted it on and just blend it all around. Again, this one was my second attempt at, actually no, this was my first attempt. Was it? No, cut that out. This is my second attempt to give them, these two guys, a spread, and it was a mistake using these napkins, because this was one of the first few times I actually used a paper napkin, and I just did not. I was just not too experienced using paper napkins, so I did not know that there were actually more than two plies on them. So I just took out one of the plies, and it's still very thick, as you can see, because it just does not blend in with the background. You can still see the whiteness of it. Well, you learn, you know. Although I'm quite happy with the background yellow, you know, favorite. This one I'm happy with this. I'm actually quite happy with this. Although it's nothing, again, nothing extraordinary, just basic watercoloring. I just use a dry sponge to sponge over all the watercolors and just use some black ink to drip down all the inks. This is the same model, a local Singapore model. I just cut her out like this. This one, I could be happy with this spread if not for this ugly part. I use this, if you can see that there's some black, this I actually erased off something, a mistake, using this black brush. I'm also unhappy that I failed doing that, but oh well. Again, this one is this was an IKEA cutout, some pillows. And what I love about this spread is I actually used a newspaper cutting of some face doodles, and you can see all those face doodles everywhere, face doodles. Just some people, some faces sleeping, just with glasses, smiling and frowning and everything. So I was quite attracted to those doodles, and I cut them out and used them for this background. Again, all this, I just use recycled paper and just watercolor it, and just use a ballpoint paint pen to do this pile. This one was quite well received on my Instagram. This was Rapunzel with Flynn Rider, and again, I can tell you it's not on purpose, but I guess Flynn and his nose just faded. He's not supposed to have good noses in any, you know, print art or anything. I accidentally cut off his nose. So this one I cut out the, you know, the sun symbol from Tangle using my Cricut machine. So this was a stencil. I also used some newspaper cuttings as a background for this. And this was also traced from a printout text journaling for the journaling section. I quite like how I colored this because it gives like a glow on top of the surface of the night sea. This one is also inspired by someone. Again, I believe I did credit the person on my Instagram. I'm so sorry. I don't keep a note right now with me. I should have. But if you want to see who it was from, you can go to my Instagram. I just use an old storybook cut up into heart shapes, and for this journaling pieces. And actually all this modeling paste, failed modeling paste stenciling, but I just went along with it. I think it just gives it its character. I actually outlined all these hearts using pencils, graphite pencils. This one was also inspired by someone. I do believe I credited the person on my Instagram, and I think that I believe that the artist did acknowledge that. Thank you very much, whoever you are. I stamped all these flower petals, flowers, using whatever flower stems I have on hand, and just colored them using my red watercolor. And here are some. I did a border with some modeling paste, some bark looking wooden bark looking textures, and just paint it away. this, oh gosh, this is not something I'm proud of because it's a mess. Oh, an IKEA cutout again. And I actually tried bordering this whole piece spread using charcoal, and right now, as you can see, my hand is already dirty with it. Ah, let's just not talk about this. This one was something I envisioned. I've been wanting to do this spread for a couple of months because I wanted to do. I had a vision of a cat, stranded cat, inside an upside down umbrella in the middle of a night ocean with the moon just shining like that. Again though, it's really not that easy to, I don't know, at least for me, I find drawing a beaming moon in the middle of the night is not an easy fit. I find it very difficult to get that glow using just paints. And the second next page is dark. Okay. This one I'm quite happy with this. This is just random doodles. I copied these doodles off Google and recreate that on a recycled paper and watercolor it using some cheap water paint. And yeah, this is actually my first time using a India ink to give them some shadow. I quite like the effect. And all these journaling things are from this Tim Holtz Ranger collection. I did some modeling paste here, some script writing stamps. This one was also inspired by an online artist. I also believe I did credited her in my Instagram. I did not follow thoroughly like how she originally did it on hers, but I did give my own touch with the borders and everything. Again, just watercolor, and I believe all these for the border I did use poster paint, and for this white highlights I use white correction pen instead of white gel pens. Stuck again. Okay. Yeah, so this is a magazine cutout I did of a local Singapore artist painting some shop houses. I was attracted to them, so I cut them out for this spread. And although the entire background was a mess, I was not happy with it. But oh well, I already did it, so what can I do? Right. This one was also not something I was happy with. I tried using a shimmer pearly watercolor for this spread, but it just did not work. Actually, this was a magazine cutout from some kind of Alice in Wonderland kind of theme. So I cut out the worm, and yeah, I don't know why I did this black part. It's just stupid. And I believe I used crayon for this blue border. Just some splatters. Oh well. Really not proud of this. This one though I like. Basic, but I like. I doodled this, actually not my original idea, but I doodled these foxes using some Google search in which someone doodled some foxes, and I copied this and I colored them using, I believe I used my Copic markers to color this. Yeah, and yeah, this one I think I use acrylic paints for the background, just brayer it off, brayer two colors, just this dark teal color and yellow. And for the bottom, I believe I use my Ranger oxide ink for the brown. Okay, I believe it was vintage photo. And some, if you can see here, there are some script stamps also. Again, stuck because we are at the ending of the book. Okay, this one is something I'm quite proud of. I really like how this turned out. But again, well torn. That's one thing that will happen if you don't protect your pages. But this one is a printout I did from some Google search again. I just cut out this barrel. I believe this is a beer barrel. But I love the quote for this because I wanted something to do with barrels, and I found this quote: never pick a fight with people who buy ink by the barrel. And that just resonates with me because I love to write. I love to write, and you know, your writing can hurt people, and can, if you want to. So yeah, I love this. And I just did some modeling paste, some stenciling. I colored this using Copic marker. I actually also use my acrylic black ink and put them into a spray bottle, so you can see the spray effects here. Some spray effects here, if you can see. Yeah. This one, also I can't remember who I got this drawing from, but it's from Google too. Yeah, I can't take credit for this, but I really like the drawing. So again, this one is, the background is just simple, just some stenciling of, you know, the bars, some leaves, modeling paste, and I use acrylic paints for the background. And as for the purple border, I use oil crayon, just some cheap oil pastel crayons. I confess I'm still not very good using oxide sprays because I just cannot understand how they work. Because this thing, these are mustard seed oxide sprays from Ranger, and it took me days, literally days, for them to dry. I don't know why. So these are just simple light bulb doodles I did, and just paint them using my watercolors. And I actually outlined them using my zebra markers, but not knowing that they will smudge upon using water, you know. So these are all smudges, but I just let it be, just make it into a character for this spread. And for the strings, for the wires, I actually use 3D glitter glue for gold. I don't know if you can detect the 3D-ness of it. Stuck again. Okay, this one, I'm also quite happy with this. I used a tissue paper for the background. I think the tissue paper is one of the remains of a previous spread I did. And this one is also a cutout, a magazine cutout I took out from a community magazine. And just did some stenciling using acrylic paints, alphabet stenciling, just simple, you know. But I love the colors. I believe I used Brea for this, just white paint, and I don't think it was white paint, I think it was gesso. Just gesso and dark teal color. This one was a mistake. I did not expect these results, really. Again, I tried using shimmery, pearly paints, acrylic paints for that. And because to my naked eye while doing this spread, I could not see the shimmer. But upon, you know, posting it on Instagram, I was like, oh my god, this is so shiny. But I don't know if you can catch this shimmer here, but it was really shimmery. So this one is also a cutout from a Google search I did. I stamped some musical notes. And this one, I don't know what I was doing, but whatever. I just pasted some Ranger journal notes here. And some toilet paper rolls, stamps for the circles. Again, I tried using the India ink for the shadow. And if you can detect, there are some brown border here. I used vintage photo oxide Ranger stamp, ink stamp. Again, this one was a drawing I printed off Google, and I colored it using my own Copic markers. Quite happy with this because I tried to use the same color themes for the whole background. There's some stenciling, some modeling paste, and this is where I live. Yeah, this is my first time actually printing out my own journaling pieces. You know, I have a whole bunch of journal quotes now, just using my inkjet printer. So yeah, you can see some spreads of ink here, but I don't really, not really bothered with that. So this is my last spread in this journal. Some coronavirus inspired theme with a girl wearing a mask. So I printed this using a recycled paper, so it's a lot of stamping, a lot of I used just a simple stencil for this modeling paste here. Quite like the color combination. Yeah, so to avoid criticism, do nothing, say nothing and be nothing, and have no life. So yeah, I guess that's it. So I hope I will be able to show you my process of doing a mixed media spread using my upcoming new Monologue book, which is actually the exact book I use for this. It's just new, so it's more thin. You can see the difference. An unused one and a totally used one. And I can tell you, I did not tear any paper from this, and I did not stick any two papers. I use every single paper for all my spreads. So hopefully I can do the same. I don't know how long I can finish this one, because this book itself took me 18, 19, 20, 21, almost 4 years to finish. So, well, I think that's about it. Thank you everyone for watching. Hope you enjoy. Happy journaling. Bye.